Welcome to Gayatri's Cook Spot. I am Gayatri Kumar and today I'll show you how to make these Ooty Varki biscuits, which are very famous here in Tamil Nadu. These are so flaky, almost like puff pastry, or in north you get curry biscuits, right? It's of the same consistency. If you haven't yet subscribed to my channel, please subscribe to it. Now let's make the dough. To 150 grams of maida, add a little bit of salt and 50 grams of sugar and mix it nicely. These are mildly sweet cookies, not too much sweet. But if you want it sweet, you can add more sugar and add some oil or melted butter and mix well. It should be crumbly in texture. Now we are going to add enough water to make it into a soft dough. Butter, puff pastries are usually made with butter, but varki biscuits are made with oil or ghee. You get the most basic varki biscuit, or you also get some ghee varki, nei varki we call it. So ghee varkis are also available, which are quite expensive than the ordinary ones. And there are some differences between them. So let us soak the dough for 2 hours or minimum 2 hours, and then just take it onto the counter, knead it again, and by the same time you need to preheat your oven to 180 degrees centigrade. So we haven't yet kneaded the dough, just mixed it and just let it sit for 2 hours. So now we're going to knead the dough for 1 or 2 minutes until it's nice and smooth, elastic and soft. Don't have to knead it a lot, because the 2 hours resting time itself will have given strength to the gluten, and it would be really easy to knead the dough now. So now the dough is ready. We're just going to roll it out into a very large disc. So add some oil, because oil will help you roll it out into a really nice thin disc. Otherwise you'll feel it very tough to do. At first the gluten won't spread easily, so it will bounce back. So if it bounces a lot, you need to rest the dough for 1 or 2 minutes and then roll it again. As you can see, it's bouncing back a lot. So I just let it rest for 2 minutes and again I started rolling it. Now it's okay. The gluten has relaxed and it will easily roll out. You need to roll it out into as thin as possible. If you have seen baklava recipes and all, so they roll out the dough very thin. The same way we're going to roll the dough so thin. It should be a slightly transparent. Your counter should be, you should be able to see your counter through the roll. And now add generous amount of oil and maida. So we're going to laminate the dough. This is what creates that flaky texture in the varki biscuit. So you can either use oil for this, or you can use ghee for that. So ghee makes it more rich, and it's also expensive when you go and buy store-bought ones. So after applying the oil and maida mixture, we are just going to fold the total rectangle into 3 parts, like a letter fold. Now again we are going to apply oil and maida, and then you just mix them together, and again you're going to do a letter fold. And after doing this, we are going to rest the dough for another 2 minutes, because again it will bounce back if you start rolling it again. So you just rest it, let the gluten relax, and then you can roll out the dough into a rectangle. I'm going to show you 3 shapes using this dough. So just cut it into thin stripes. Usually in bakeries they do huge batches, their counters will be large, even their dough will be so large. But as we are doing it in home, I just took only 150 grams of flour. So it makes a really tiny batch. So even for one day snacks it will be enough. But if you want more, you can actually proportionately increase everything, like 300 grams of flour or 450 grams of flour. These are they last for like 1 week to 10 days. You don't have to refrigerate them. You can just store it in airtight boxes, and then they will be crispy even for 10 days. So if you want to make a larger batch, you can do it. So I have shaped the workies, the square ones, and these are the clustered ones. Like, you just bunch up the dough and just place it on the tray. You don't have to do anything. So this is the regular workie we get usually. Just pinch everything together and just place it on your baking tray. And again, there is one more worky, that's round worky. You just shape it into a ball and place it on your tray. So we have the square ones or rectangular ones or the round workies and the normally bunched up workies. So now the shaping is done. Like the bunched up workies, you just pinch it like this so that they don't, the layers won't separate. But you don't have to do it for the round workies. Bake them in the preheated oven for 35 to 45 minutes until they are nice and golden. As there are so many layers here, it will take some time to bake. So just be patient and your results will be amazing. Just transfer them onto a wire rack and let them cool completely. That's it. Our workie is done. Let me show you the layers of the workie. This is so delicious and they make a nice snack. They go well with your coffee or tea. See how they are so crispy and flaky and mildly sweet and very delicious. I hope you like this video. Please subscribe to my channel and share your feedback. Bye.